Greetings, Chris Zirkel, Digital Learning Coordinator for the Wake County Public School Systems. We work a lot with staff members, students, in incorporating technology in the classroom, and we produce these short videos that kind of highlight, spotlight the use of technology in the schools and the impact it's having on our students. And in our conversations and our work with Green Level High School, we came across a student-led club, Green Level Football Media and Recruiting. And our video today is a collaboration. We collaborated with the staff members, the students, to produce the video you're about to see. Some of the footage has been filmed by students, and we want to just kind of, again, feature the opportunities that students are having to be able to incorporate technology that's going to, in this case, lead to career pathways and media. And so let's go ahead and take a look at this short film.
My name is Brandon Simmons, and I'm a business education teacher here at Green Level High School. I'm also the advisor for Green Level Football Media and Recruiting. The sole purpose of the club is to, you know, assist students with their burning desire to advance into the college game as a sports reporter. We offer a number of different opportunities, and we do feel great about the direction of our program.
So basically, I've been always interested in editing videos. And when I heard that we had a club here dedicated to football media, I really wanted to be able to have the opportunity to edit videos specifically for sports, since that was something I had never done before, and I like football. I thought it would be an interesting experience and fun. But I didn't have a camera, and there was no dedicated videographers at that time to film footage for me to edit. So I picked up a camera, borrowed one from the school, and at first I didn't really know what I was doing. I didn't really know how to shoot on manual. I didn't really know a lot of the settings. And to be honest, I really still don't. It's really just kind of trying to figure out what works best in each individual situation as far as like football goes. So for example, trying to find the right position during a specific play, or trying to figure out what focal length to shoot at for each specific play, what focal length to film at, during a running play, during a throwing play. And then the other thing is just making sure you're presenting the football team in a positive light and trying to make them seem more hype than they really are, to get that excitement from that video and to contribute to that tone.
I'm Emily Dina. I'm Director of Operations for Green Level Football Media. I approached the school last year not knowing how to even shoot a camera or even work a camera. I approached the school and found this club, finding Aaron Butterworth, being able to go out to practices and practice shooting, and you know, go out eventually to games, being on the sideline was a really great experience, and now has helped me do this in college and hopefully pursue this as a career. I've been over the summer to multiple colleges with the football program. I've been to NC State, I've been to Duke, I've been to ECU, and all of this has been a great opportunity to help build my portfolio and build my photography career.
My name is Erin Butterworth. I'm the president of Green Level Football Media and Recruiting. Back in 2020, I had seen on Twitter that they were looking for photographers for our club. And so since it was something that I had done in the past before, just casually, I thought it would be a really great experience to just kind of get involved in the school since it was during COVID and there wasn't a lot going on. So I decided that it was something that I wanted to try, and I had a camera from my parents. And at first I just shot in automatic. I didn't really know how to take like good quality pictures, but over time with photography workshops and just development from the club, I was able to develop my photos. I was able to shoot in manual and really expand my portfolio. And through this club, I've gotten to take opportunities throughout the school and outside of the school. I was able to shoot for the track and field team at state championships and be able to get media coverage in the infield with all professional photographers, which was really exciting for me. I've been able to take pictures for the baseball team as well. And outside of school, I've helped nonprofit organizations take pictures for their events, like their get-togethers, and just recently I took pictures for an autism walk, so I've really been able to expand inside and outside of school with my photography.
And our goal here is to bridge the high school game to college, college to pro, and we hope that our students continue to progress in that area. The focus of our videographer department is to, like our photography department, is to give students an opportunity to develop their skills with firsthand experience. All of our personnel in our club do work at practice, home and away games as well. And the goal is to fine tune their crafts so that if another opportunity presents itself on a higher level, they'll be equipped to do so.
And this club has really given me the opportunity to experiment with new things and to branch out and really find where I enjoy to film and where I enjoy to edit and how I enjoy to do those things. And I've gotten the opportunity to film different sports here at Green Level, like basketball and soccer, and really look forward to building a portfolio so that I can do media more at the collegiate level or maybe even the professional level. And building portfolio is one of the biggest things that I think this club has helped me do, because without it, I wouldn't have an outlet to be able to film. Even though I have this passion, this skill, I wouldn't have an outlet to be able to showcase it.